We're up here at Port Angeles. The Olympic mountain range is in the back. There's the Black Ball Ferry to Victoria. Yeah, it's just a gorgeous late afternoon. Looks like we got a mirror ahead of us. Bunch of cormorants up there. One thing you can't capture on video is the smells.
The winds can come up quickly here in the Strait of Juan de Fuca. Just a few minutes ago, this water was as smooth as glass. That's why it's important to be prepared by wearing immersion wear, having a marine radio, and a spray skirt.
It's a beautiful morning today out here in Freshwater Bay. Got some black oyster catchers here. Got some cormorants clinging to the cliffs there. If you look closely, there's a moon jelly there. A close up of a few moon jellies.
I scuba dive with golden masticus and jellyfish.
like we got some harbor seals up ahead. Got a lion's mane jelly here. I love paddling in water like this, the gentle swells. It's so relaxing. It's what makes sea kayaking so enjoyable. That, being able to see all the wildlife, like the river otters, seals, raccoons, and deer that I saw on a previous trip. It's really is truly a fun place to visit. Makes the 6-hour drive worth it. Our third and final day takes us down here to Lake Crescent. The side of this hill recently came down and blocked 101. The debris even spilled into the lake. The rains have started to move in here a little bit on Lake Crescent. Nature Bridge is ahead of us. It's an outdoor learning program. I like their canoes. They have a Pacific Northwest dugout look to them. It's a little choppy today out here on the lake. Afraid we're gonna have to call it a day here on Lake Crescent because the direction of the wind from the north means to paddle west, we'd be having some waves really broaching us, and that would not be fun. So unfortunately, gonna have to cut the trip short, but this is a beautiful lake to paddle. The water is a deep blue, so I would recommend coming up here to anyone that enjoys paddling, especially lake paddling.